Edison Carter, Network 23. Network 23, are you receiving me?
Shit.
This is Network 23. Intermittent voice loss.
Edison Carter to Network 23. Come on, clear this link.
Network 23 to Edison Carter. Okay, we have the link strong and clear. Your show goes live in 2 minutes. Your controller is Gorister.
Thank you, 23. Hello, Gorister.
Gorister here, Edison. Right, now you're above the incident. Descend and I'll guide you once clear of the chopper. By the way, you've got competition. There's quite a scene down there.
How long before I'm on air?
You've got 30 seconds. We'll make it.
This is Network 23.
This is Network 23. The network that means business, now transmitting live to the world the award-winning Edison Carter on the What I Want to Know show.
Two, one, go.
This is Edison Carter asking the questions you want answered. Right now, what I want to know is this. Just what happened in apartment 42 in the last 60 minutes? What I want to know is, who is suppressing the story? What is it somebody doesn't want us to know? Come with me, live and right now. Let's go and get some answers.
All right, Control, I'm going in.
Of course, do we have an update?
All we have is it's an explosion and that the area is sealed off to all but residents.
Okay, cut to the eyewitness. 3, 2, 1, go.
Well, there's reporters and Metro police everywhere. There was an awful noise and a woman come running out. They've took her off. And I think they've had to scream for him.
Hello.
Nobody'll tell us why we've got to stay indoors.
All right, Control, I'm getting out of the chopper now.
Okay, from your position, go north 300. Building 84B. Security on the main door, so I'll take you in on the east side. I'm cutting up time, Code.
Okay, Control.
I want you to turn right. Okay, Edison, there's an intersection ahead. Go upstairs and it's on the second floor. Number 42.
You got any update on that?
Apparently the wife's been hospitalized.
Yes. But Carter's right at the scene. What? We're just about to go out on air. On what authority?
Pull Carter out. Just pull him out.
Hi, Patrick.
Hi, Edison. This man say through here we no go. It's typical. First time ever we get to a story before you. Control has pulled us out.
Gorister. Gorister, I'm calling you on the link. How come this story is pulled?
It's just come down to Murray.
I'm not dropping this one, Gorister. Something smells. I'm gonna go around the back and see if I can access a window.
Edison, it's pulled. Come on in.
Gorister. Gorister! Gorister, you maniac! You... Jesus, I don't believe it! Gorister, I'm in... Gorister! Gorister, you do not leave me or anybody exposed out there.
Hey, Edison, what's the problem? Easy.
The problem is I almost got killed.
The job was pulled. I pulled you in.
You cut me off! And no job is over until I am back at base, you lethal idiot!
Edison, come over.
Don't leave this prima donna crap. Not even from the great Edison.
Bloody Carter!
Get him off me, Murray.
It's my ass out there, not his!
Now, look. Just give me a controller who can do the job. I just want somebody who can keep me alive out there. The best.
Okay, okay.
The best.
Listen, Edison, I was out there once. I know how you feel, but it stops there.
You have still not regained contact with Edison Carter. So now...
It's big, isn't it?
I don't know. It was pulled from high up. Very high.
We've succeeded in pulling Edison Carter off air, Mr. Grossman.
Yes, fortunately your instructions were carried out in time.
Turning now to ratings, we have every cause for satisfaction.
Overnight ratings, Channel 23. Low, 115 million. High, 236 million, which keeps us top network. Projections for the next hour are excellent.
Let's move to the Blipvert problem. We may have to suspend the use of blipvertisements temporarily. There have been, as you know, these side effects on viewers. However, returning to conventional 30-second advertisements will once again give viewers time to switch channels, with the consequent dip in our ratings. The very thing that Bryce designed Blipverts to prevent.
The Zigzag Corporation are very keen to press ahead, buying airtime using our Blipverts. Right now, we are the only network that have Blipverts. Unless we use them, Zigzag might deal with our competitors.
I do not intend to lose our major client.
There's probably no connection with Blipverts. But good heavens, isolated instances of this phenomenon have occurred throughout history. People do sort of blow up, spontaneously combust, you know.
No, I don't. We need some more informed opinion on the matter. So I have asked Bryce to meet us on the video link. Now, he's our top man. I want you to leave him absolutely to me.
The head of research and development on the link, sir.
Hello there, Bryce. I need to talk to you about...
I'm rather busy. I succeeded in computer generating a parrot on screen.
Oh, my congratulations. Whatever next?
It squawks.
I wonder if you could find time to illustrate to the board here this little hitch we have on your blipverts.
Put simply, the human body has millions of nerve endings. Each carries an electrical charge, individually very tiny, but in combination surprisingly large. Normally people burn it off, but in inactive people it just builds up. Now, because I designed Blipverts to compress 30 seconds of advertising information into 3 seconds, it appears the brain violently stimulates these nerve endings simultaneously. In some subjects, it causes a short circuit. Some particularly slothful, perpetual viewers literally explode. Simple as that. I've got rather a good example of one on this Rebus tape.
Oh.
It won't be so damn simple when Blipverts go global. My God.
Now look here, the only people who are that inactive are pensioners, the sick, or the unemployed.
I take it that your Rebus tape is in an extremely safe place.
Of course. But look, it's not my problem. My brief was to find a way to stop channel switching. I mean, you know, I only invent the bomb. I don't drop it.
We think it might affect sales if people begin to suspect.
Well, don't tell them then.
Unfortunately, one of our reporters may have got quite near the truth. We have to be very careful.
Well, fire him. We could always kill him.
You can't just smash a window in. I mean, holy shit, it's a vertigo!
Laura, I'm putting you with Edison Carter. He's the best we have at Network 23. A bit volatile, but good.
Yes, I heard. What was the story he was pulled out of?
Hi, Edison. This is Theora Jones. I've managed to prize her away from World One. I've warned her you're a charmer.
Hi. Oh, how's the head?
It's fine. How's yours?
Right, where do you want to start?
No trouble, or I stop your pocket money. You know the rules.
Yes, we do. What do you say we start by breaking one? See what you can get on this rash of reporters being pulled off hot stories for no reason.
Edison,
Sort of, access the inaccessible?
Edison, leave it! Now back off, I mean it. Christ, after the kind of material you normally bring in, what's so special about some microwave oven going pop?
Oh, come on, Murray. Since when did people guard exploded microwaves?
Right, let's have a go.
Hey, there's no way through there. That's the executive level.
I know. Let's try up through the plumbing system from the lower level where there's no security block.
How the hell?
I accessed the security systems Mr. Carter asked. This place is about as inaccessible as I can get.
I'll leave you two together.
All right, Theodore, what do you got on the line apart from the dirty pictures?
There's a missile missing from AKG. Oh, that's hot. Don't see that?
Uh-uh.
Oh, an assassination of a whole medic team in Bolivia. How about that one?
Give it to Joe.
Bryce is a problem. Saudi's onto this computer-generating people business. He doesn't want to know about Blipbert. And we must keep him on air, then.
Unless Bryce can sort out their effect, we simply can't use them. You've seen the Rebus tape. It's just terrifying.
We have no choice. We're committed to the campaign. And the Zigzag Corporation's advertising contract with us is massive.
Massive or not, if this gets out, Network 23 is in serious trouble. We've got too damn close to the truth twice already.
Fuhrer, run that again, that last bit.
Network 23
is in serious trouble. We've got too damn close to the truth twice already.
Did they now?
Stand by control. Ready to 15. Can I have sound and camera check?
What's that crew doing on the roof?
Camera fine.
Well, apparently they're covering Ben Chevitt's departure to New Tokyo to sign this big Zigzag contract.
This promises to be one of the most momentous meetings in the history of telecommunications. Or perhaps I should say the history of communications of the world. And we're looking forward to a long and happy association.
Sorry, Mr. Chevitt, we had a camera problem. Can we do that again, please?
We've always felt that the viewers are the most important people.
Hey, what do you guys think you're doing? This is my story. Want it back at control, I'll handle this one.
Okay, Mr. Carter, it's all yours.
I understand, sir. You're off to New Tokyo to finalize the Zigzag contract?
Yes. This will be a major partnership between Network 23...
What's the Blipvert problem?
What? Good God, man, this is completely out of order.
Too damn close. Twice already. Hey, Mr. Cheviot.
The problem is whether I can trust you. You see, we've just heard that...
I don't know how much of that you got, Control. Are you busy tonight? Maybe all night.
Mr. Carter, we hardly know each other. A rebus. I think that's a kind of puzzle. Mysterious pictures.
Pictures. All right, where am I relative to your control?
You're 5 floors above me. I'm getting all clear on the security system. Hang on, Edison. Just a few moments. Okay, hold your position. Stand by. We have the level.
Got a problem. I'm at the entrance, but I need the code.
I know, I can see you. Right, now it's Bryce Lynch. And that's 71088. Oh, Libra might have guessed. Okay, try BZ2UH.
No? Try again.
Right. How about 1J2FI?
Yes, we'll do that. Yes, sir. Of course, there'll be the usual expenses. We can do that. Yes, sir.
Got a nice accident, then?
It's the parrot man again.
Another one? He must eat them by the dozen. Where are we going to get one at this time of night?
Squawk! Not a parrot. A nasty little burglar. To be cornered. And perhaps hit.
So how about the playback unit?
What do you say?
Try the playback unit.
How do you know?
Tell me a kid that ever puts things away.
Even clever ones. I know all about little boys.
Yeah, I just bet you do.
Camera check, please. I'm getting you out of there. Move.
Excuse me, you'll turn right.
What's the problem, Control?
Intruders. Two. They activated the alarm in the elevator. By the way, they're armed.
Oh, great. Any idea who they are?
No, but they're outsiders, not network men.
Is this a change of plan, Control?
No change. I'm standing by on the basement camera.
This is level 6. We're going up. Look, I don't want to be difficult, but... we're going the wrong way. 126 coming up. If those guys are out there...
Okay, go ahead. Go left. Four-way intersection. Do not cross the intersection until command. Okay, go. And there's somebody else in the system.
Thank you.
But he smashed my bike.
We made a deal, Mr. Boigle.
Why?
He saw the Rebus tape.
He's the best-known reporter on air. His show is top-rating prime time. He satellites globally.
And he saw the tape, Mr. Grossman.
You know what you're saying, Bryce. I run a television network, Bryce. Not a goddamn hit squad.
He's quite rational. Keep Carter on ice in the cryogenic unit.
On ice?
Meanwhile, his reports keep coming in for a while, so no one will question his sudden disappearance.
Bryce, I don't want to appear ungrateful, but how do we keep his reports coming in, huh? A seance?
No. I compute the physical characteristics of his head, then I print his memory, his synaptic circuits.
His synaptic circuits?
His mind, you know. The brain is only a binary computer, a series of on-off switches. Then, Mr. Grossman, I can generate this man onto the screen from my computer. He'll be able to continue his program, and no one will know. But he will, in fact, be computer-generated. Just like the parrot.
The parrot?
Yes, Supervisor, please.
Supervisor?
Yeah, I'm tracing Mr. E. Carter. That's Edison Carter.
Ident number?
Personal ident code 74928B DG6629.
Incident?
Yeah, auto accident, section 5, area 23.
No, we have nobody answering that description.
While the coffee all remains black, unsweetened,
to predict no advantage possible, and all parties are standing down. While over the Red Sea, two cooler satellites have drawn a beat on both parties on a 14-hour observation. Unless countermanded by accords, they will auto-fire simultaneously.
This coffee stinks.
Stinks, odorous, pungent, offensive, offense. The guilty party will be reported to network president Mr. Grossman. This is an automatic complaint system.
Four more unaccounted domestic explosions finish the roll. These figures citywide and overnight. Next up, market trends.
Dump down all the information in the mind and replay it at will. Then I can eliminate any information I don't want. My parrot squawks in much the same way. But my research funds must not be starved. I have to have time and money.
Do you ever sleep, Bryce?
Only physically. For the moment, the computer pie is only enough to generate a human head and too many coordinates for the rest of the body, which naturally won't be needed. This is the future. People translated as data.
Does this thing reproduce him as a reporter is all that I'm concerned about. This whole situation is becoming very disturbing.
Circuits are randomizing a little. It'll settle, though. I need more time on the recall generator. It's bouncing. It takes a while for the frame store to read out all the information.
Max Headroom? God damn it! Get that babbling clown off the screen! Kill it! What kind of a screw-up is this? This is a joke, Bryce.
Leave it alone! Don't you dare touch him!
Him? This junk is a machine. This is not Edison Carter. It is a computer-generated geek. It is useless. Do you understand me?
I understand your opinion, Mr. Grossman.
Then understand this. You abandon that garbage, you apply this unit to the crucial matter of the Blipvert problem. I want that resolved, and I want it fast. This parrot project terminates now.
Perhaps you don't understand the potential of this development.
I understand the potential of this situation. This electronic oaf has a record of what Carter saw on the Rebus tape. Smash it. Carter here has the same information. However, reluctantly, we must somehow get rid of him. I do so hate wasting an employee.
I'll have Bruegel and Marla handle it. They relish performing good works.
I don't like that Mr. Bryce. The little shit's too clean. Gives me the creeps.
Cleanliness is next to godliness.
That young man's got some brain on him. Be worth a bob or two.
Not a great pair, our Mr. Bryce.
Nice head, though.
Is the body still alive?
He's a bit alive. Nasty knocking head, that.
Silly boy. Who's a silly boy, eh?
Hands are rare and expensive items. Worth more than cameras. Luddite.
Nightingale body bank, priority red, urgent requirement, male right leg, condition upper body and materials, seem decapitation victim.
That's it. They're short at Nightingale's. Mr. Bryce didn't say kill him, did he?
Nah, but he did say get rid of him, though.
Okay, Naz.
What's the bonus for a live dead body?
Clinical brain death only carries 20 points.
Yeah, but he's still warm. There's got to be value in that.
There is. 20 points. Goodbye.
Brain banger, that one. Cheers, folks.
Live on arrival. Very tasty angle, that.
Opens up possibilities. What are we going to do with Mr. Bryce's little toy here?
Well, he said he wanted it safe, and he wanted it in good hands until he needed it.
He did, yeah. He said that.
This is big time
television.
Day after day, making tomorrow seem like yesterday. You know, we said there's no future. Well, this is it. This is Blank Reg talking to the Blank Generation.
Hot and live from big time television.
Reg.
And next up, more of the same.
Reg.
Shh. Have a nice day. What's up?
What is a cross-hatch generator?
Hello.
We've been billed for one.
Oh, yeah. Oh, they stick anything down. I think it was some bent cabling gear that Poncho slipped.
Reggie, darling, how do you expect me to run my business like this? You don't help, you know.
Oh, they were cheap. Hey, why don't you just write in, money out, and leave it at that?
And if the credit terminal wants to see the figures, what do I do, huh? Just wave the back of an old envelope at them?
Crash, Reggie. You smoke too much, Dom.
Reg, if you didn't nail your jeans to the floor every night, they'd escape, so don't talk to me about personal habits. We have just got to find something better than those bloody old video clips.
Dom!
Just because they're free doesn't mean to say they're good, you know.
I like them.
And Private Reg.
Mr. Seer, Reg.
We have got something for you.
Very special bit of gear.
Yeah.
You being an expert.
You just press this white button here and key things in.
Things? The bloody hell is it?
Actually, it's the red button.
No, it's the white.
But you've got to plug it in anyway, Reg.
I'd never have known that. How much?
Oh, well.
Hello, Marla here, can I...
Mr. Bruegel? Nightingale's here. That body you sold us has taken a while.
Sorry, Reg. Bit of business. Talk about the transaction later, eh? Try the goods first sort of thing. Hey, hey. Leave it. We have got a deconvenience. Now the very witching time of night, when churchyards yawn and hell itself breathes contagion to this world. My head upon your lap, lollipop, lollipop.
If I smash this hand, it'd still be at the body bank. Oh, it's gonna cost us this is.
Have you seen a blonde man with a camera?
Excuse me, have you seen a man in a gown carrying a camera? He's escaped from the body bag.
Thank you very much.
Good morning, televisionists. First up, Dr. Duncan at Dawn, the video symptom show.
Fiora?
Dr. Duncan's video symptom show.
Dr. Duncan, I was suffering from a dreadful anal pustule, and it's giving me absolute agony.
Just pop the old buttocks against the lens, would you? Fiora.
Edison, for God's sake, where are you?
Keep transmitting, I'm locating you.
Morning. I need your address. I'm in bad shape.
Hello. Nice to have you visit. Please enter code. And while you were out, these were your messages.
Digital watch tunes. You can enjoy them all on this cassette. Remember? And the classic. Plus many, many more on Digital Watch Tunes Volume 2. Available now from ZigZag.
Hello there. Call this number and find out what an incredibly nice guy God is. He won't keep you waiting on the line. He won't hang up on you. He's sitting by...
My God, what happened?
You don't even know what it is. It could be anything. Might even be a bomb. Plus, what did it cost, Reg?
It's free. If it doesn't work, we throw it back.
If it doesn't work, I what? Christ, Reg. We can't afford even decent programs, let alone a crossbatch rotavator thingy or whatever it's called.
Geronimo!
Hello? Go on. Go on.
This is live and direct.
Murray, what am I on air?
Identify station.
Enter
data.
Go on, Reg. Enter big time.
This is live and direct on.
Big
time. Am I on air?
Bloody hell.
I beg your pardon.
Hey, it's speaking to us.
Your pardon.
You say something.
Your pardon.
Talk to it.
Hello, mate. I'm Reg. This is my partner, Dominique.
Big time. Hi. Both of you. Welcome to Big Time. You want to check these ratings? I seem to have an audience of two.
Great. Terrific. Where'd they get this?
Hey, what's it for?
Hello, and welcome to Big Time Television, live and direct. It's Big Time Television, the station where two's company and three's an audience.
Where does he get all this from, Reg?
And
data.
Data. Bloody data. Believable.
Data.
Chaos is not helpful. Please be seated.
Ben, what exactly have the ZigZag Corporation said?
The whole campaign is organized around the use of our blipverts to prevent channel switching. No blipverts, no deals.
This contract is huge. We can't just reject a transglobal campaign. We cannot withdraw blipverts now.
We can't go on using them. They're lethal, goddammit.
That is not proved.
That tape wasn't proof. What the hell do you need? A live demonstration?
As well.
I find that tasteless. It is very clear. The blipvert is a brilliant breakthrough. Half a minute of advertising in 3 seconds. It's magnificent.
It is. It's also killing people. We buried that kind of crap decades ago. I am not prepared to risk my network over it.
Ben, I am talking ratings. And I'm talking people.
Same thing.
We must come clean on this. If you won't, then I will.
How's the cold?
Okay, how's the head?
I think it's worse than your cold.
Well, there was a connection loose on one of the tubes, which I fixed. But we still have nothing from the other night. Can you remember anything?
Not a thing except bits. I can remember Bryce's lab and the barrier arm and some weird noises like voices. I think it was Bryce and somebody. And some creep standing over me with a scalpel. In a body bank.
Body banks are for dead people.
Yeah.
And whoever was in the system the other night certainly knew what they were doing. I nearly lost you.
You're going to get the chance to lose me again tonight because I'm going to go back to Bryce's studio.
Edison, are you fit enough? Okay, I'm going back into 23 and you'll need some clothes.
Made just one piece. I won't explain. Just stay tuned the big time. More later.
Yes, of course. I'll prepare the contract immediately. Thank you so much. Goodbye.
Hey, Reg, come in quick.
What's up?
We've got a client. Some TV repairer. I think old thing Ian there is perfect for them. They love him.
He goes on the blink too much.
But that's just the point. They want to use that.
Big time television. Ratings 1,000. Ratings 1,000. What am I supposed to
think? Forget it. Stage fright?
Reg, this is incredible. Over 1,000 viewers. You might get paid this month. What the hell is that?
His ratings?
Max, you're kidding.
Well, why not? Max Headroom, 2.3 million. Well, that's what you want, isn't it?
Max Headroom. He could have his own show.
Hi, this is Max Headroom here, and I know you see me sitting here talking to you, and you think, wow, isn't he amazing?
And maybe sometimes you even think in your own funny little way, I wish I was Max.
Okay, this is the
Max
Headroom show, and I'm Cocky Swagger, Max Headroom. And it's great to have you all back with me again. I'm sorry, there's a guy who keeps moving around over there. All right, well, I wish he'd just damn well keep still, for God's sakes.
I'm trying to do a show here.
All right, I'll take it again from the top. Okay. Hi, this is the Max Headroom Show, and I'm... Well, I'm sorry, I've lost it. All right, just roll a video, will you, please? Now!
Now! I don't care to...
Jesus!
Well, thank you.
You've left my ring by the soap. Now is that love? You cleaned me out, you could say broke. Now is that love? The better, better, better it gets. The more these girls forget. That is love. You won't get dressed, you walk about. Now is that the teasing glances push me out. Now is that the tougher, tougher, tougher it gets. The more my lips frequent. Now that is love. Beat me up with your letters, your walkout notes. You still find me right here at home. Legs up with a book and a drink. Now is that love that's making you think? You called my bluff, I'm not so
Just because they're free doesn't mean to say they're good, you know.
I like her.
Beat me up with your letters, your walkout notes. Funny how you still find me right here at home. Legs up with a book and a drink. Now here's that love that's making you think.
I reckon that all these high-rating TV shows like Dallas and Dynasty are put on by the Russians. Think about it. There's two evenings a week when most of Britain and America are only looking in one direction.
Right.
Straight at the TV.
Right.
Now, who knows what's going on behind their backs, right? Now, just think about what could go on if they show another royal wedding. It's the perfect time to strike. That's why I've come up with this plan. To make sure we're safe for at least half an hour a week, the Max Headroom Show is only going to show videos that the Russians will enjoy, too. Iran has issued a statement accusing Iraq over Iran's denial of Iraq's allegation that Iran has lied about Iraqi planes attacking Iran positions on Iraqi territory claimed by Iran. Experts on both sides are studying the statement.
Hardly surprising. 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 We'll be right back.
Part of the music, swagger, biz.
A lot of young people ask me for advice about
forming a band and making a hit record.
And what
I say at this stage of the game is, why not? Okay. Now these days things happen fast. You got to build up a reputation, get your image right, make a video, and write some songs too. So, my advice is to get a note from your mom. Pedro on big time television. And what I want to know is, don't Eskimos ever get bored with their weather forecast? It's Max. Max
it's on big time.
And what I want to know is, if you're all watching me, who's watching Network 23? A network with a great future behind it. As they say, when you're buying suppositories with friends like those, who needs enemas? And when
go
gazelles
for it, Max.
Are running away from a lion,
you son of a bitch.
So let me get your pardon.
Go for it.
We'll get the car phone fixed. Probably just a growth microchip. Mr. Bryce.
You were supposed to come back and report. I should have had no need to call you on the view phone.
Well, my mum wasn't feeling too good and we just popped round to see her.
You did exactly as I asked.
Oh, to the letter. One got rid of and the other locked away.
Good. Locked away. I admire the clarity and precision of your response. Perhaps, therefore, you could clearly and precisely explain this.
Big time television. Well, these rock things are all very well if you like them. But, you know, no ordinary people like you and... well, ordinary people like you oughtn't to be afraid to speak up for classical music. I know it's hard to get the videos, but it's worth hunting them out. Mozart, that's my tip for the top, as I think you young people say. Interesting guy, old Mose, or Mosey Baby, as I like to call him, wrote some terrific songs. And of course, he could write for all sorts of voices. Sopranos, altos, you name it. Mind you, rumor has it that he wrote most of his big hits for a tenor.
Boy, does he go cheap.
I'm not sure that we're really supposed to cover topics like this, but we've had a letter from a young man in London who says, and I quote, "I went to the doctor just the other day and said, 'Doctor, I've got a sexual complaint.' 'Really?' said the doctor. 'Who from?' Ads.
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 And is that why their population is so
very like that other bloke? Film of him, is it, Mr. Bryce?
It is very like that other bloke, and it is not a film. That Mr. Marlowe is a complete person. And that machine is the coded mind of the dead Mr. Carter. Soon I will be able to reconstruct anybody on a screen. Even you, Mr. Marlowe. So accurately that even your own mum would know it was you.
You might care to call it the Phoenix, Mr. Bryce. My word, you could have all your politicians in little boxes. It's very handy.
Now, Mr. Boygle, where is big time television?
We could move up the Polly show, pull in an extra episode, and get the standby show online.
We'll have a vacuum by midnight.
We could rerun the Rat Killers. It went megabucks last global.
We could go porno early.
What do the analysts say, Ben? What actually did it?
It's only 2%.
2% is 26 million consumers, Ben. Once they start switching channels, it's war. You know that.
It happens all the time. We're used to it.
But if we're still running blipverts instead of regular adverts, there wouldn't be any channel switching.
Blipverts have only been off the air 10 hours, and already the ratings are 3.7% down, Ben, not the 2% you suggest.
I'm going to reinstate blipverts. And that's final.
More class. Reggie, I take it all back. You are brilliant. This Max thing will keep you in beer tokens forevermore.
Tom Starving, now I'm going to micro some alphabetti spaghetti lettuce and tomato sauce. You want some?
Do me a favour.
This Max has got a weird facility. His data store is huge, right? So it can access a lot of info, right? Clear the command and away with the mixer. Hmm? But he just doesn't build data, you know. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. He jumps. And it's not just information. It's like intuition.
Oh, Reggie, darling. It's only just a bloody old voice box with a load of bytes. Root it and off it goes. It's just other people's phrases it uses.
And how come he's got a sense of humour?
And this is XTC with Making Plans for Nigel. Nigel.
Or as we call it in the swagger.
Music biz, MPFN.
Plans for Nigel. Nigel's hope.
Those two goons have him much. Not in their league. Doesn't add up, Dom.
It adds up on my figures. Max is making this station.
What if the real owner wants him back?
Over my dead body.
It might be. I'm going to put the wheels of the bus back on, just in case.
Okay, Bryce. Let's start with the other night.
Give me a graphic.
Well, we're holding. It's okay, we've steadied. 28 and 42 have taken a dive. Get analysis on this.
That was unpleasant. Not half as unpleasant as it's going to be when the blip bursts have their ultimate effect. Somebody, sometime, is going to make the connection.
Hey, look at this. That climb is exponential.
The figures are minute, down in the thousands.
Let's take a look anyway. They may have something worth chasing.
It's vacation time again, and why not? And of course, I'm getting calls from young men asking me what they can wear on vacation that is really stylish. And we'll help them pick up a little something on the beach. And why not? Well, guys, the simple answer is...
flip-flops, yes?
Flip-flops. That rubber gets so sticky in the heat, they pick up everything on the beach. Cigarette butts, bottle tops, chewing gum, dead cockroaches, typhoid, and if you're really lucky, a big blob of tar to walk all over your towel. Facts.
And it's time to reach the unreachable, undo the undoable, unscrew the unscrewable, unspeak the unspeakable, and
play the untouchable.
They're unsingable.
Sorry, I started that.
Free yourself.
Facts.
Down all the time.
around the nuclear powers have just denied rumors that the world's waters are being polluted by
nuclear waste.
They say that the pollution is being caused not by them, but by all the dead fish we have today in the sea.
Okay.
Max! What I want to know is, why are the only funny lines on this show the ones behind me? I still don't understand that one.
What I want to know is, if caviar is a rich man's food,
and you left him like this,
now, Bryce, where is it?
That pirate station. I think Edison Carter might have it.
Carter? But you told me he was... Who did this to you?
Carter.
How do we find him? How, damn it?
Boy, Glamala, they know.
But it is a significant distance.
How much?
Oh, I should think.
At speed, it'll be much fuel. Thank you very much.
Instructions are delight. Delight our greatest sorrow.
Seven little girls sitting in the back seat, everyone in love with Fred. I said, "Why don't one of you come up and sit beside me?" This is what the little girls said all together now. One, two, three.
Keep your mind on your driving, keep your hands on the wheel. Keep your snoopy eyes on the road ahead.
Oh, look!
We'll have fun sitting in the back seat. Hugging in a kiss with Fred.
Okay. We're here. Close the doors, lads. Hey!
Do you offer the body bank?
Don't move. You're not going anywhere.
Murray, are you getting all this?
You realize what this means? Do you want to transmit?
It'll never happen, Carter. They won't transmit it.
What do I do, Ben? Do what you have to, Murray. Okay.
We interrupt this program for a special news flash. For the details, over now, live and direct to Edison Carter.
Mr. Grossman.
Head of Network 23.
You're going to tell me exactly what I want to know about Blipverts, the whole story.
The world is watching live and now
on Network 23. Tell me, sir. When did you first learn that Blipverts cause people to spontaneously explode?
What a load of bollocks.
Parents are only one rung above politicians, though. You always know when they're lying. Their lips move.
The story's been told, but the show must go on.
Hey, hey, I'm not stopping now. I'm not going where you're going. I'm going out on my own. My show goes on. And I'm going to take over your TV. I'm going to read the news, check the weather, talk about sport, meet the public, give away prizes, walk the dog, and play videos. I'm going to be in my own home, talking to superstar after superstar after superstar. The first one is... Ding! See you then.